Hey guys, a very good evening to all my crypto believers. So have you been curious about what's happening in the market? Don't you worry, the Coin Monks got you covered. Okay, so before starting with our updates, let's quickly quote today's headlines. Bitcoin dumps $2,400 after settling $67,000 high. Luxury shoe brand Jimmy Choo floats first NFT collection on Binance. Cardano-based decentralized exchange RavenDex reveals demo. Revealed, the crypto fans who secretly paid $4 million for Pharma Bros' Wu-Tang album. With our video. Firstly, I guess just like the volatility of cryptocurrencies, my happiness index is also volatile. Well, just today morning I covered how BTC had set an all-time high and now it dumped $2,400. Anyways, as the world's largest cryptocurrency broke all-time highs yesterday, traders sold it in droves. According to statistics from several sources, Bitcoin dropped roughly $2,400 this morning after hitting an all-time high of $67,000 yesterday night. The all-time high was achieved after a futures exchange traded fund went live on Tuesday with over $500 million in Bitcoin exposure offered on the first day of trading. However, traders rushed in this morning to cash in on the winnings, sending Bitcoin plummeting by hundreds of dollars. According to data from analytics tool Bybit, the movement resulted in almost $220 million in futures liquidations. For the uninitiated, liquidations occur when leveraged positions are automatically closed off by exchanges brokers as a safety measure. On BitMEX, the greatest single liquidation order occurred with a Bitcoin trade worth $10 million. Shorts or traders betting against growing prices accounted for 66% of all liquidations, with crypto exchange FTX alone accounting for $58 million in Bitcoin futures liquidations. Meanwhile, the Bitcoin sell-off put a temporary halt to last night's green surge in the crypto markets. Well, moving to our next news, but before that, let me ask you a question. Which shoes do you wear and how much do they cost? Personally, I prefer Reebok and they cost around $2,000. But here's the surprise. The next news which I am covering is about a shoe company named Jimmy Choo, where each shoe costs around $100K to $500K. Dude, my PC is even cheaper, whoa. Anyways, on the Binance NFT marketplace, global luxury fashion company Jimmy Choo has unveiled its first ever NFT collection. The collection will be accessible for 6 days, according to Binance, and the NFT was created in partnership with New York artist Eric Hayes. The world of NFT is slowly growing, with worldwide corporations looking for ways to get on board. The outgrowth of blockchain technology represents a one-of-a-kind opportunity for all types of authors to possess transferable copyrights to their works and be properly compensated for their efforts. There are also 8,888 mystery boxes available for purchase, which are separated into four scarcity tiers. A single super rare Jimmy Choo Eric Hayes Love 100 Glitter, super rare cards, rare cards, and neutral cards. Beyond the Binance Smart Chain network, the advancement of NFTs is becoming a topic of discussion on other blockchain networks. Despite the launch of NFT marketplaces by centralized exchanges such as Coinbase, Crypto.com, and FTX, to name a few, NFT transaction volumes across historical marketplaces such as OpenSea are increasing dramatically. This demonstrates the rising desire for digital collectibles and the establishment of marketplaces to meet it. Now, as far as our next news is concerned, we all know how important demos are. Remember that manual which you threw away and then could operate a machine yourself? Yeah, it happens. Quite sad. So our next inscription covers a demo which you should not ignore. Cardano is incredibly popular these days and we just ran a story on it 2 days ago. RavenDex aspires to be the most popular DEX in the Cardano ecosystem. RavenDex, a Cardano-focused decentralized exchange, revealed this week that its front-end demo is now available for users to try out. When RavenDex becomes online, users will be able to give liquidity and create a market pair on any native Cardano token for others to swap while taking advantage of the Cardano blockchain's performance and cheap costs. The RavenDex team is working to create one of the first decentralized Cardano exchanges. In addition, this presentation comes only days after an overcrowded private sale round for early adopters in which they contributed in exchange for the utility token Rave. So now, while moving to our last segment for today, ever thought that super chats were weird, like giving your favorite content creator money so that he takes your name and uses swear words for your friend? Sounds dull-witted, no? Well, this is nothing. Some people have a huge and die-hard fan base. And hence, next is our headline. Attorney Peter Skolich arrived at the Eastern District Courthouse in Cadman Plaza in Brooklyn at the end of July. The lawyer was no stranger to the courthouse, but that day he had a unique task. Listen to the lone remaining copy of Wu-Tang Clan's Once Upon a Time in Shaolin album to see if the material was still intact. The CD was simultaneously condemned as an aristocratic stunt art scam and embraced as a clever protest against digitalization's deterioration of music value when Wu-Tang auctioned it off for $2 million in 2015. Martin Shkreli, a hedge fund and pharmaceutical tycoon who was swiftly becoming one of America's most loathed men, was the buyer at the time. Once Upon a Time in Shaolin was confiscated by the US government before being sold to Pleaser DAO, an organization known for collecting digital memorabilia celebrating anti-establishment rebels such as Edward Snowden and the Russian band Pussy Riot. Pleaser DAO had previously purchased an NFT of a popular meme and made ownership shares available to the public at a low cost. Johnson noted at that time, "It's almost as if the Louvre chose to fractionalize the Mona Lisa and release a bit of it for the public to hold. It's unclear whether something similar may happen in the Once Upon a Time in Shaolin reality." According to Bosung Mur, "You can't do much with the record. However, I believe that all of those constraints, or at least a part of them, would be open for debate if Pleaser DAO had a good enough notion." On the concept front, Johnson is convinced that his DAO can deliver. He describes his company as a Willy Wonka factory of NFTs. "We want to do outrageous stuff while also having a significant charitable component," says the group. Well, crypto is getting famous indeed. So, we would now wind up with our assessment for today evening and meet you all tomorrow with even more interesting stuff. Until then, you may consider joining our Telegram channel for free crypto signals, visit our blog linked below for guides, reviews and tutorials, and subscribe to the channel and get daily updates about crypto market. Lastly, with this little favor of CoinMonks, we hope you stay updated. Thanks for watching and have a nice day ahead.